Hello everyone, it's Petko Aleksandrov, and before I show you how I generate and create the strategies for the expert advisors, I will share with you how important it is to use reliable historical data, a complete data, before you do any algo trading. No matter if you are working with strategy builders such as EA Studio, FSB Pro or any other, or you are a developer working on expert advisor, or you're a trader and you just want to backtest your expert advisor, you need a reliable historical data. This is the first step, and you can see in the generator settings in EA Studio, the first thing is the data source, the historical data that you will be using, and this is essentially important, and I will share with you some secrets and tips that many traders don't know. And it's a huge mistake if you are missing a good historical data. Now you can see in my data source that I have many resources from different brokers, and I will show you what is the difference. Usually we get the historical data from the MetaTrader, from the broker, and for the beginners, the historical data is all that information which we see in the previous bars and candlesticks. When we put the mouse on the closing of any bar, we see the open, the high, the low, and the close. And these four values form the candlesticks and the bars. And all the bars that we see before the current moment, this is all historical data. And this is what we use to backtest strategies and expert advisors, which I will show you later on. Now in EA Studio, we have the option to import the historical data from the broker, which is the best thing you can do. There is script for MetaTrader 4 and for MetaTrader 5. You just need to download it from here and then just copy it. Go back to your MetaTrader, go to File, Open Data Folder, click on MQL4, go to Scripts and paste it right here. After that, you can close the folder and you go to Scripts, right click and refresh. This is how we will compile the script and it will be available here. For MetaTrader 5, you will need to right click and go to Modify, from where you can compile it. The refresh trick works only for MetaTrader 4, which I am using at the moment. After you have the script, what you can do, drag it over the chart. From inputs, you need to select how many count of bars you want to use, the spread, and if you leave it to 0, it will just round it to the next higher number. So for example, if I'm exporting for pound dollar at the moment, you can see it is 9, 10, 11. So if I export it when it is at 9, it will round it to 10, okay? It will round it to the first higher round number. And if you have commission with your broker, you need to enter it here. The easiest way to see if you have commission is just to open one trade with one lot and to see if there is commission or not. Let me show that to you. I will just click one click trading and I will go for one lot and then I will just buy. It's a demo account which I'm showing at the moment. No problems to buy at any moment. Let me show you where is the terminal. Here it is. And you see that I have $10 of commission for opening one complete lot. So when I'm using the script, I will need to enter that $10, which is set by default actually. Zero spread, I will leave it to zero. And a maximum count of bars, 100. You can increase it to 200. And you click on OK. And this will export the bars. Right click and I will remove the one click trading so you can see it right over here. What you notice is that on M1 and M5 I have 65,000 bars. Now this is because there is limitation from the MetaTrader. You need to go to Tools and click on Options. A box will appear. You need to click on Charts and Maximum Bars in History enter 999 as much as you can, same with maximum bars in chart. Click on OK, and then you need to press the home key on your keyboard, which will force MetaTrader to load more historical bars for you. Do this on all time frames, just press and hold it as long as the chart moves. Usually it will move like that, but because I have already done that, it's not moving. And after you do that for all time frames, you will need to drag the script one more time over the chart and click on OK. You will see that now I have more bars for M1, just 468 more, but for M5 I have 97,000 bars, for M15 69,000, and so on. And when this is ready, I can go to File, Open Data Folder, and click on MQL4, Files, and here is the historical data that I have just exported from MetaTrader. After that, go back to the EA Studio and drop these files in this drop zone. It loads the data and the data will be imported. Now, if you click to the generator, you will see that I have these data right here. Tukuscopy-demo-1 for pound dollar, and here are the number of bars. Now, the problem is that most of the brokers, nearly all of them, provide very poor historical data. And the good thing with EA Studio is that we have a great statistics for the data and we can analyze it. For example, you see that I have data from different servers. I have from Tukuscopy at the moment. The MetaTrader demo, which is by default at the moment, comes from the GFD. And you see that for pound dollar, I have 71 days off, which is a gap, meaning that this data is missing. Now let me show you what other data I have. I have, for example, FXCM. Let's check what we have here. If I go to data, data statistics, FXCM, it's right here. Here I have 2 days, much better, but this is just for H1. If I go through the others, you will see that there are some gaps. Let's go to M1. For example, I will go to data, data statistics. Here I have 3 days, which is still good. I haven't used that broker for a couple of months now. I'm not sure if their data is reliable at the moment or not. But this is the way you can check if your data is good. You should look for the days off. You better not have more than 2 to 3 days off. If you have 10, 20, 30, 40, this means that there is a gap in the data. Okay, and you can see that I have a lot of data from a lot of brokers, but recently I used just one of them, and it's a great solution that we have recently on our website. It's free. And in the next lecture, I will show you how to use it and how to get the maximum out of it, because it's really, really important, one more time, to use reliable historical data before you trade with expert advisors. I will continue right in the next lecture. Cheers.